Okay, so this session will be about all the recent defense updates and all the information. This will not be a Q&A session. This will not be something like I'll not answer the questions. We will do a separate session for that. For now, this is all going to be a Q&A. To be a information session. So, okay. So here we begin. I'll just turn off the comment sections in case someone has to ask. We'll do a separate live for that. Okay. So recently you must have heard about the 6th generation fighter program that US is going ahead with, and that even a very prominent person in US defense channels told about flight testing of a 6th generation fighter. So people were talking about how 6th generation fighters are going to be a thing in the near future. Everything is going to change. India has not even made a 5th generation fighter while US is going forward to a 6th generation aircraft, and how they are going to produce the fighter in few months or few years they will have the production and all. First of all, this is not going to be the scene. The thing is that they are testing a technical demonstrator or flight prototype. It is not a complete fighter. It is just basically a design, or a design they are testing. Not necessary that they have tested all the technologies, not necessary that they have all the parameters. This is simply before making something, you have to test concepts, you have to test things. This is not going to be a fighter that is going to be in production anytime soon. It is going to take years, if not decades, before anything comes out of this. So the 6th generation fighter is not going to be something that you will see by 2030 or so soon. Do not expect such things. Second factor to that thing is that you do not know what the aspects of technologies are. You do not know what the baseline of 6th generation fighter is. People are talking about 5th generation, 6th generation. Saab also even claimed their Gripen as a 6th generation fighter, but it is not. As you and me know, it is a 4.5 generation fighter and it is not a 6th generation fighter. So saying that 3rd generation anti-tank missile, 4th generation anti-tank missile, it is nothing until you have a basic laid out for a 6th generation fighter. My guess for the 6th generation fighter is that it will have a certain amount of AI or artificial intelligence, and it will have certain features. It will be more stealthier. It might not even have a contemporary design which we are used to. So there's no necessary hurry that there's going to be a 6th generation fighter as of now or even before 2040s. So do not expect anything to come out of it. Recently we have seen certain photos. I'll post them on Instagram and I'll do a post on it, and I'll also post this video on my YouTube channel so you can see the photos there too. And people are claiming that that is the design of the 6th generation fighter US is producing, or US is testing. But do not be so hopeful. If US has a 6th generation fighter which is operational, why will they invest so much money in the F-35 project? Like F-35 even today has hundreds of issues. F-35 today has millions of things which are not working as they expect it to work. But still they are going ahead with the 6th generation program. So you have to think about it. And it is basically a technology demonstrator at this stage. It is not going to be something which is going to be in use in the recent future. In the near future, it is not going to be a thing. So this was all about the 6th generation fighter program of the US and what we know about it yet. The images, I will do a post, or I'll just post it on my YouTube too, so you can go and check out. Also, to the people who have not seen our YouTube channel, the link is in the bio of the ID. You can go and check out, and you can subscribe and support us, because it is going to be more meaningful if I upload things on YouTube, because you know, recently my ID was hacked and it was deleted. All my data was lost and years of work. So I would like to have a backup, and YouTube is much more viable option, I feel, when it comes to saving your images, saving your videos and all. So that is one more thing. Now coming to the new developments on our own front, the Su-30 MKI developments. I talked about it in the last video as well, but I'll talk about it right now too. People must remember that in 27 Feb dogfight, there was a certain issue called the videos of Abhinandan sir was jammed by Pakistani AWACS and all. These were the claims, and the communications were not secured, and that is why he was shot down apparently. But then after that, we heard about the Israeli firm winning a tender or winning a competition for providing SDRs, which are software defined radios. SDRs is basically the link is in the bio, bhai, you can go and check there. So what happened after that is, after a certain amount of time, IEF went panicking, and IEF went for towards their much delayed program of getting SDRs, which are software defined radios. In that is a basically encryption technology. Like your WhatsApp messages are encrypted, similarly with the help of softwares and with the help of software encryption, you make your communications much more secured with the help of SDR or software defined radios. IEF wanted to upgrade the entire fleet to SDRs, so they ordered for some 400 SDR from Israeli firm. India also has developed its own SDR for Army and Navy, but that was not functional because in an aircraft the space is very limited and you have to miniaturize the technology. And Indian SDRs, I feel, were not small enough or were not compatible enough with the entire fleet of aircraft. So IEF went to the Israeli vendors and bought them. Recently, we have heard that the Su-30 MKI has been integrated with the SDRs, not the entire fleet, but a few of them have been successfully tested with that. So now we can hope for a future upgrade of all the entire fleet, and we can hope that all the fleet will have encryption. So the communications will be much more secured and the data links will be much better. So this is about Su-30 MKI. Also, one more update was that indigenous glide bomb was tested from Su-30 MKI. These bombs were developed in 2015-16. We have been hearing about that, but today we know that it has been successfully integrated. So that is one more thing. A recent development was also we heard about the ATAX barrel blast. We are not much clear about the scenario of what happened, but it is being said that ATAX suffered a barrel blast during testing, and that is why an inquiry report is being asked. Further developments will be known after the reports are public, so we are not very sure about what has happened yet. So this is one more upgrade. HAL LUH cleared all the trials recently. I posted the paper, the letterhead, which you also. So we are hoping for more certifications, and sooner than later we expect some sort of LSP order. We are waiting for the LSP order of LCH, which is the Indian Light Combat Helicopter, and the LCA order. Those are going to come by the year end, but we are also expecting a LUH order now. So this is also one more development that is going to happen in the near future. So these are the few things that happened in the Indian defense. One more important topic was the demonstration of hypersonic technologies. Many people have asked me why the hypersonic technologies are so essential and why India needs to have its own expensive program, and why we cannot join the Russian BrahMos 2 program like we have planned. So why is it necessary for India to have their own hypersonic missile? The answer to this lies in the historical lessons we have learned. You remember that whenever a critical technology is made, like whenever you make any sort of critical technology, be it ICBM, be it a nuclear missile, be it any supersonic missiles, or be it long-range missiles, cruise missiles, sooner or later, an international body is formed. And the international body's work is to control the export and control the technology proliferations. And whenever any nation has that technology, they get to sit in the council. India has missed the train on nuclear technology and all, but today we have an opportunity to sit in a future council that will be for hypersonic missiles. And this way we will also be part of the team, and we will be equals amongst US, China, Russia, etc. And we will be able to say that we also have this technology. If you are not going to allow us to sit in the council, we will not follow the rules you make. So this is going to be a beneficial thing for the Indian military and Indian defense. Second, hypersonic technologies is not just purely military based. It can be used for civilian applications too. It can be used for space applications as well. So like instead of having it can make launching satellites cheaper and easier with time. So this is one critical aspect of hypersonic missiles and hypersonic technology. This is not the first time India has tested it. This is the second. First, Israel tested a hypersonic scramjet engine. Now the DRDO have tested their own. The duration of test was just 20 seconds for this test. So the missile only went for about 40-42 kilometers, because the missile flies at the speed of Mach 6, which is 2 kilometers per second. So 20 seconds, about 40-ish kilometers. We are now planning to increase the range, increase the duration of flight. So sooner or later, you will see a missile which is going to fly for like 200 seconds, 400 seconds, 5 minutes. This is going to increase the range. And by 5 minutes, in 300 seconds, the missile will be able to go 600 kilometers. That is a very good speed, and that is nearly unstoppable for even the modern air defense systems. So this is going to be a bigger weapon than BrahMos. Surely a BrahMos 2 will come, but it is going to take 10 more years. So this is one critical development for Indian defense. This is one more factor. Recently we have also heard about cancelling of the carbine deal, the 93,000 carbines from UAE Karkal. The deal was hanging for 3 years despite being a fast track deal. Now what we are expecting today is to have indigenous rifles take place and replace the carbines. Few possible rifles or carbines which can replace the Karkal ones are JVPC, which is MSMC, the Joint Venture Protection Carbine. That is one. It is a specialized carbine that was made for the Indian forces. It uses a special MINSAS ammunition. This is one example. INSAS-1C is also one contender, and I have heard that many people are talking about INSAS-1C now. I have also done a post like 1 year ago in which I told about the possibility of cancelling a tender. So INSAS-1C is one more competitor for that. And the third one that is going to be a game changer if it happens, that can be your SSS Defense P-72 carbine family. It is a rifle family, but it also has a carbine version. I recently had a talk with the CEO or the head of that company, and he told me that he's very hopeful for the orders of Indian weapons. So this is one more factor, and the short range air defense deal, which is also being cancelled. The BHO system is supposed to be cancelled because of indigenous options being present. India does not have a BHO category thing yet, but India is working on something. DRDO is working on something which is called which is basically a CIWS mounted on a truck. So this is a DRDO project. They have learned some lessons from Afghanistan tour of by US, and they are developing a basically AK-630 CIWS mounted on a truck. They showcased it I think 1.5 years ago, and they were very hopeful about it. So maybe we'll see an indigenous short range air defense system in the near future. Maybe it can be coupled with some missile systems and all, because we do have short range missiles and all, so we can do that as well. So that is very much possible. Vertically launched Astra is also one thing that is going into works, so that is also a possibility. But we will have to wait and see what happens out of this, and then only we can comment on this deal. Coming to PLR systems, as Aditya has asked us, what is PLR systems? Okay, so PLR systems has a joint venture with IWI. They basically make IWI weapons in India. They make the Tavors, they make the Negev, they make the pistols. So RK Sharma sir, who is leading the PLR systems, I have had few talks with him on social media, not personally. So he was very hopeful for the future orders. Although there are some issues here and there, but he expects army to order a lot of equipment from PLR systems. So these were basically some defense updates of in recent times what has happened. Also, one more important thing was about Rafale fighters. Indian Rafale fighters have a certain system which is not present in any other foreign Rafale system. It has a side cheek edge or side cheek mount which is not present in any other Rafale in the world, and it is being something that is talked about much, because Indian Rafale are not like any other and they have a lot of modifications. People have been talking a lot about what it is, how can it be, and what type of system it is. In my own analysis, I feel that it can be a side cheek mounted radar system. See, a radar has only 60 to 80 degree angle of view in front. So if a jet fires a missile towards the target, it has to guide the entire missile till it reaches the terminal phase where the seeker kicks in. So it is not always possible for a fighter to do that, because the enemies also can take actions. The enemy can also fire the missiles towards the target. It can also have to evade missiles, etc. So this is not always possible. So the side cheek mounted radars actually help the jet in guiding the missile, even if the jet is not directly looking towards the target. So I have done a post on it, and I'll post it. You guys see the analysis and see it. So this was all for the defense updates and all. We'll do a Q&A session after this is over. I'll save this video on YouTube. Just go subscribe. The link is in the bio, and support us on the YouTube channel as well. Thank you. Jai Hind. And